what that was, man. Come on. 356. 34. Again. AJ, 34.
Get ready to get me to the one whenever.
5-1.
Here
we go. 1, 2, intro, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to do this twice. Do it again, do it again.
Come on, tell somebody.
That's my key, that's my God, that's my strength, here. Build it.
Oh, Jay.
Take every wrong and you make it right.
going to You Made a Way. What key is that normally in?
It's in A, so we can do that. Travis Green.
Travis Green?
Yep. It's in A. For her key though? Her. That's too low for her.
I might have to go to this, be sure.
If we do King of Glory.
She's coming up now.
Oh, okay.
Come
in, son. You turn the words off,
y'all. Is that good?
Yes, sir. That's it.
That's it. That's it. 6-5. 3-4.
Stay on that board, but I gotta turn it into some jump in a minute. E flat would probably be a better key.
That's what I was saying. If we did King of Glory, she'd be good. But Joe's gonna come up.
She's doing it now.
I know. I was saying King of Glory is an E flat.
Everybody's break off, break off.
You know, I woke up today thinking about the power of God. How he has all power in his hand. And then I woke up.
Hurry up, she's waiting for you to get
about the promises of God. And how that if God has made a promise to us, which we all know he has, every promise that he made to Abraham.
Go ahead and play the song.
If you don't know all of the promises of Abraham, you need to go home and study. You don't even know what you're waiting for. But when you read it and you say, "The promise that," then you have the power, somebody say power, to reach into the heavens and pull down those promises. You have the power. Until you turn on the switch. But when you make a decision to flip the switch and say, "I'm tired of darkness in this area. I'm tired of not being able to see my way through in this area. I'm tired of all of that. I'm ready to see my way clear." The Bible said the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. I'm ready to see what God has for me. When you get tired of all of not having that, you will flip the switch and say, "Today marks the day of change. Today marks the end." When you flip the switch, you see the power. It's within your reach. That's what I'm telling you today. It's within your reach. Hit somebody and tell them, "Flip that switch. Flip it. Don't give up on it. Because it's a promise from God. And it belongs to you."
She might want to go straight to the you move mountains, because she probably knows the verse.
They are yours today. I want you to take a minute and turn around and tell somebody that you love them and you're glad to see
play
them.
Play it.
Go, Josh.
You don't know what they went through this week, tell me. But tell them, "I'm so glad you made it. I'm so glad." If you're watching online today, we're glad you made it. We'll be right back.
webs? Yeah. Thank you.
How's that?
That's good. Thank you.
Glistening stones of various colors. God is flashing.
I said, God is flashing. Moreover, because I have, and this is what he says, and marble slabs in abundance. Moreover, because I have set my, now, this is a house of his God, but he's talking about his affection. He said, because I have set my affection on the house of my God, I have given to the house of my God over and above. Somebody holler, over and above. I have given over and I've given above all that I have prepared for the holy house, my own special treasure of gold and silver. He is saying, I have my own special set of gold and silver. And I have brought it because I prepared for the house. And he did it diligently. He didn't just get to church and say, okay, what is it now that I owe God? What do I? Did I pay it? Babe, did you pay it? Who paid it? Did anybody give it? Oh, Lord, I don't know if I can afford to give it. None of that. You understand? He prepared. They put it on the screen today because you need to see that this is the word of God. I prepared for the house of my God. Today, I know that you have prepared. We have not been able to do what we've done in this church without people being consistent. Look at somebody and say, thank you for being consistent. Thank you for being consistent in preparing and putting God first. And if you are a person that struggles in that area, man, we want to help you today. Because when you give to God what belongs to him, he will do what we just sang about. Make a way. Late in the midnight hour, turn it around. He'll go into the bank before you do. Prepare the way. He'll go into the doctor's office before you and prepare a way. He'll go in the grocery store. Lord, we need him to go in the grocery store. He'll go in the grocery store and prepare a way. He just does little blessings out of nowhere that lets me know you did that just for me. Have you ever had God do something just for you? I mean, seriously, let me see your hand. You're looking at that, look at this. You know God did that. Because you have been faithful and God is faithful. And he's faithful to stand on his, he's faithful to bring his word to pass when we are faithful to stand on it. So today I want you to get your tithe and your offering. And I want you to prepare to always come prepared to give to God. Not just with your phone handy, but I'm talking about being prepared in your heart. I'm talking about not just giving because it's the thing that we do at this time. But I'm talking about giving from your heart. Your heart that says, God, this is still worship to me. We're not spinning in circles. We're not hollering. But this is very much worship. Because anytime you lay something that you actually need on the altar, it's a sacrifice. And when we lay down a sacrifice, heaven moves on our behalf. So don't miss an opportunity for heaven to move on your behalf. Because you don't understand that this is worship too. Tell somebody this is worship too. So today we're going to bring our tithe. If you're looking at me, some of you are looking at me, what is tithe? Tithe is 10% of your increase. It's whatever God has given you. Y'all blessed me so wonderfully on my birthday. You gave of your heart. You gave of your substance. You gave of poetry. And whoever put those pieces together, I do want you to know I've read them. And they bless me. And for those of you that even if you go out and buy a car, Lord, have you ever seen cars cost so much? I mean, if you get one worth reading, you know, and it's just, I understand that you made a sacrifice. And I looked at all of that and I said, God, now, because of what they've done for me, what do I owe you? And I brought God the tithe of what I figured everything up to be. I brought it to the Lord. I brought it to his house. And I worshiped him with that. Do you know what he's going to do for my next birthday? Yeah. Ooh, tell somebody. You ain't seen nothing yet. Y'all ain't seen nothing yet. I dare you to get your expectation out there. He will blow your mind. It's normal. It's the exceeding greatness of God. Your tomorrow should be better than your today. Ooh. I believe him. There's faith in this building. I want you to pull it out and stand on it, because God will be faithful. So bring your tithe to him. Any way that he's increased you, just learn to give it by faith. It ain't always one of those things you can just give, just like, oh, I'm just going to give this. No, it takes faith. And then we put a seed with that. And that says we expect a harvest, God. Not just in a future way out there, but I expect it before I leave this church today. Do you know somebody could cash out you for what you are in need of right now? Does anybody believe that?
Hey, Cal, make sure you don't forget when Sid is going to come up and sing.
And then say, no, bridge. I just want to be a blessing to them.
I wrote it down.
Tell Rod. Today,
yeah, I've already reminded him too.
If he wasn't planning to do something. So what he's saying is, I want you to believe me. I want you to dare me. I want you to challenge me. And I want you to stand on my word, and I want you to praise me. Because I got you.
Yes, he does.
I've got you. Yes, a thousand shall fall at thy side. 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. You know how many lives were lost in the pandemic, but you live. So I'm going to live on purpose. I don't know about anybody else, but I'm going to live on purpose. I owe God my life. You owe God your life. And periodically, I'm going to remind you that he lets you live. And you're living on purpose. So you be faithful to him. He will be faithful to you.
Yes, he will. Yes, he will.
If you want to give on a device, you can. If you need an envelope, they'll be happy to hand you one. There might be one in the seat pocket in front of you. But everybody should be moving toward doing something, even if it's only, God, I'm going to thank you. I'm going to lift. There they are in the aisles. They've got them. If you need an envelope, even if you need to get an envelope and bring it up by faith and lay it on this altar. Today, I feel like somebody just needs to be obedient to God. You need to give to God what belongs to him today. God is like standing there at the, he's standing there and he's saying, come on, today is the day. I'm going to bless your life. I don't know who that bears witness with, but I want you to obey God. If you got your pledge for our building fund, which we will be able to sit in our chairs.
Y'all see how Manny let us know who he is today?
Yes, come on, help me thank God.
Yes, sir.
How many of y'all have seen a change?
Glory to be doing that, man.
And
mess around and pull
something. It didn't take us 5 years.
Yeah, did you stretch before you started today?
And then kept putting it off and putting it off, and you didn't know what was going on.
How many
y'all
balls was cracking while you were doing all that?
You better thank God for a ministry with integrity. I said, you ought to thank him for a ministry with integrity. Bishop said the wall's coming down, and it did. And it is down. There is room for more. We're only able to do that because you are being faithful. You are being faithful over and above. You're preparing for the house of the Lord. I want you to lift up your seed. I want you to lift up your tithe. And I want you to just wave it in the presence of God. If you're watching online, you know how to give online. Probably, if not, there'll be instructions on the screen. There are instructions on the screen. But every person,
you want us to go back into that song?
Bless you in a financial way today.
Or no?
Lift up your hands.
Lord, what? Do what?
You want us to go back into that song?
I don't think so.
That
wouldn't make sense.
If you don't need it for you, you need it for somebody that
we're going to do King of Glory.
Absolutely. Father, tonight, today, we lift up our hands and we lift up our gifts and we bring them to
welcome
your house.
This place.
To bless you.
Said you don't know
out of the increase that
way before your
us.
Time, baby.
And I pray right now that as we bring to you your portion, that you are already preparing our next portion. You are already working the deal. You are already opening the door. You're already making the way. You're already providing. You're already releasing it in the atmosphere. I thank you for blessing your people. I thank you for blessing those who are on the verge of stepping out into to becoming entrepreneurs, those that are on the verge of stepping out into opening their own businesses, to opening other streams of income, Lord. We understand that you have to command wealth to come to our hands, not just because we want a better house or a better car, but so that we can establish your kingdom. We need finances in order to do that, Lord. And we thank you for blessing us. And as we are faithful over what you have given us, we thank you that it prepares us for what you're about to give us. I am expecting you to move, God, and I'm asking you to move and meet every need. Somebody in this room, somebody all watching us online, they need a miracle in their finances. Lord, just blow us away. Turn it around so fast that we cannot help but run and tell it.
Amen.
And say to God,
that sounds like an Ashanti song, bro.
Who?
You don't know who that is.
Don't let us waste our strength.
That's that redemption song.
No, it ain't. That's the song.
No, it ain't. It's an R&B song.
It's an R&B song.
Tears in the snow, them Ashanti.
They did.
We ask that you would lead us, oh God.
Oh, man, that's funny.
That's T. White.
Hide and guide. We give you the glory for it in Jesus' name. Somebody shout amen. Amen.
Was it Kelly Rowland or Ashanti?
Lay it on this altar today.
It was Ashanti.
Do that as I'm going to.
Yeah, Nelly. Yeah, that was Ashanti.
It was Ashanti and Nelly.
I want to encourage you to bring it with joy because that means we expect God to move in our lives.
Hey, AJ, what if we just started playing?
We bring sacrifice of praise
into the house.
I got more better for you.
Let me tell you something. God must be moving for people.
This is our plan.
Because people are not going to continue to do things
like
this. Cash your pen
on the wall.
If he is not moving for them. Today we celebrate him. In just a moment, we have a preacher extraordinaire that is about to take this pulpit and continue our conversation on prayer. Have y'all enjoyed prayer? I had Pastor Chris preach last week about prayer. Pastor Travis preached before that about prayer. I don't know that I've ever heard either one of them do any better than they did the last time that they spoke. I spoke about not losing your altar. God is talking to us about prayer. And I'm telling you, on yesterday, we had about 195 people. Y'all hear me? Walking around this room. Just praying and calling on Jesus. I'm grateful for that. When a church prays, something happens.
Man, that's worship,
I'm
though.
I'm grateful that we're surrounded
that's worship.
By prayer. We're surrounded by ministries that believe in prayer.
You said T. White
prayer.
Produced?
Prophetess Calloway is here. Said T. White she believes produced? In prayer.
Yeah,
that makes
absolutely.
Sense.
Absolutely. We can't do it without Jesus. So now that you're comfortable, get back up on your feet one more time.
Get ready for King of Glory.
Pastor Joseph Anthony is going to come. Get ready. The word of the Lord. He's looking like a preacher today. All skinny and everything. We're going to feed him some fried chicken after church. I want you to open your heart and your mind, and I want you to be prepared.
The one you talk about in the court?
Whatever it is that God has for us. If he stands here and just teaches to us. And never raises his voice. It's just as powerful as if he hollers, as if he stomps his foot, because it is the word of the Almighty God. Amen.
One, two, three.
So you open your heart and prepare to receive, and he will come. It'll be the next voice that you'll hear after.
The West, God.
Do it again.
everybody in two.
Sing it with us this morning.
Get ready to invert. Get ready.
break out.
You fade that, Will.
Playback, guys. Playback.
Come on, give me this.
Wanna be aren't you glad to be in a house this morning that values the presence of God? I said, aren't you glad to be in a house that values the presence of God?
Yeah, right here.
Say it.
Because God is host with. He cares about how you host him. You put his glory in one room and people get hemorrhoid. You put his glory, his covenant in one room and statues fall. But you put his glory in a house of Obed-Edom who knows how to honor him and everything connected to him is blessed. I'm glad to be in a house that the presence doesn't just visit, but he resides here. And if you're glad to be with him this morning, I need you to throw your hands up and throw your head back and tell him, I just want to be with you. I just want your glory.
6-5.
I just want your presence. I just want your power. I just want to feel what it feels like to be next to a powerful God. Move in this place. Come on. Throw your weight around and have your way.
6-5.
I just want to be with you.
5. What?
Bless him. Bless him.
Come on.
Again.
I don't know what you're waiting on.
Let him know when you want the loop.
I might just set it off.